Hello. I like to make today dinosaur cake. What we need for this recipe? First of all, we're using two round spring baking tins. First one is 22 centimeter diameter, which is 8 3/4 inch, and smaller one, it's 16 centimeters in diameter, which is 6.5 inches. All centimeters and inches will be in the description box. Please do have a look. So we have two baking round pans, and we needed two boxes or packets of vanilla cake mix. If you like it, you can use any of your choice or your favorite recipe. So for basically, once we mix and bake according to instruction on the box, now our cakes are completely baked and cooled down. So we have two cakes, one larger and one smaller. Now, once they cool down, use a serrated knife to level both cakes. After that, what we do is we use a cake board, which is, you can use a round cake board or square, and we use two different type of coloring. You can use a butter cream frosting, or you can use a simple vanilla frosting from the supermarket. The first one, it's we tinted with sky blue gel for the coloring, and the second one we tinted with leaf green gel for the coloring. So tint as much as you happy with color. So what we do is first is we place small amount of blue frosting. And we just place our first cake. I will not place on the middle because I actually want arrange small mini cupcakes, just a little bit. It's up to you. This is just a purely option. So I will place somewhere like that, sort of on the right side. So what we do with the first cake, we apply small amount of frosting, just small one, just thin layer, to make sure we seal the crumbs. So keep going with the first cake. Once you place small amount of frosting on the first cake, what we do with the second cake, we use a green color frosting, and we do not apply anything on our second board because we do not want attach our cake. So this cake will be placed on top of a second one. That's why we just need only to apply small amount of green frosting, just spread to seal the crumbs, just like this. Once you finish with both cakes, what we do is we place in the freezer for at least 30 minutes to make sure all crumbs are sealed and we can easily decorate a cake. So once we're done it, what we do is we place both cakes into freezer for about 30 minutes, roughly, something like that, to make sure the our first layer is basically nice and hard and all crumbs are basically set. By the time when cakes are resting in freezer, what we do is we make chocolate dinosaurs. For this, we're using basically silicone chocolate mold type of. I purchased from eBay. It's very, very cheap, but it's very useful because you can make this sort of chocolate dinosaurs for cupcakes, mini cupcakes, for the just a normal cake, or just simply chocolate dinosaurs. So it's coming in four different variety. And what we do is basically we place on top of a small plate or tray to make sure it's secure, because we place them in the refrigerator. So, and we use dark chocolate melts. Also, you can use dark chocolate and milk chocolate as well. So, place your dark chocolate melts in the microwave, or use or melt them on top of saucepan with the simmering water. And what we do is we start using just a teaspoon. And just place small amount into each cavity. Make sure it's filled up so well. And just keep going like that until you fill up entire mold. Once you fill up all cavities of the silicone mold, what you do is just carefully tap to make sure get rid of all the bubbles. And what we do is next, we place into refrigerator to make sure it's set and hardened. And we repeat process to make it more, make sure it's enough to actually cover base of a first cake and a second cake. Once you make enough dinosaurs, as you can see, they're really, really great. And basically, if you have any imperfections comes out of the mold when you take chocolates out, simply use a sharp knife and just carefully shave away to basically the shape of dinosaur. You can use all the shavings to melt again. So turn out your dinosaurs onto non-stick baking paper once they're all done. And we took our cake from the freezer. As you can see, it's nice and hard. And what we do is we apply a second layer, thick layer of blue buttercream frosting. And something do with a second cake, which is green frosting. Then we transfer a smaller cake, which is covered with green frosting, on top of the first cake with a large spatula. Once you apply a thick layer of frosting on the first and second cake, use a large spatula to transfer small second cake on top. And what we do is now we simply use our prepared dinosaur to attach with our chocolate. What we do on the first line, something we will do on the second layer. So we just simply keep going this way on the second layer as well, and put it all around both cakes. Once you attach all the dinosaurs, in total we need about three times use silicone dinosaur mold, which is one bag of chocolate melts will be enough. So what we do is we have some biscuits, which is we place in a double bag, and we crushed with rolling pin to represent the sandwiches we place around the cake, and we have some basically dark chalk beads. They look like stones. We use them for these stones, and we also place few like a dinosaur nest, which is we use a speckle type of jelly beans, say the medium size, and we use them for the dinosaur eggs. And for the trees, best of all to cut it night before to make sure the trees actually set. I use just a simply green fondant and use a Christmas tree type of cutter, which is could be as a pine tree sort of as well. And we will use those for the trees. Also, if you like, you can just use green color candy melts and pipe in the shape of the trees, whatever you wanted as well. So let's decorate it. Once you arrange all your dinosaurs around cakes, what you do is use dark chocolate bits to make it nest and place few white color jelly beans inside for dinosaur eggs. For the trees, basically use a knife to insert into cake, make small insertion, and just place it in as far as the trunk goes. As you can see, they stand very well. If you cut out them a day before, they will set and dry, which is makes them excellent. They actually keep shape very well. And also, if you like, you can just arrange small mini cupcakes around your main cake. As you can see, we place crushed biscuits around for the center, and with mini cupcakes, basically use a brown color paper liners and leftover of green frosting. As you can see, the using silicone chocolate dinosaur mold is great, because this kind of chocolates they actually can stand, which is really great. You can make as many as you like. I hope you like this simple creation for dinosaurs cake. Everything will be in description box. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Until next time, goodbye.